All right, folks, so we're doing this video since we've had a bunch of questions asking about the difference between open cell foam insulation and closed cell insulation. So we're going to give you the differences here. One of the differences you'll notice on the right, you'll see the open cell insulation. The R value is 3.6 per inch, and the closed cell insulation on the left, right here, is actually six an R value of 6 per inch. And I'm going to try to zoom in. There you go, so you can see it. So that's one of the obvious reasons or differences between one and the other. You will get a higher R value with the closed cell than you would with the open cell. Now, another difference when you hold it in your hand or if you can feel it is the closed cell insulation right here is very rigid, so it is hard. If I tried to poke it with my finger there, it'd be very difficult. And then the open cell insulation here is very soft. I can, as you can see, I can poke my finger through it very easily. Okay, so there's some of the differences between the two. Now, the open cell insulation here off to the right is what you would like to have in your attic if what you're looking for is just insulating the attic better, or like on walls, like on 2x4, between the 2x4s on a wall, for instance, on a wood-built home. If, like here in Florida, since we're the capital, the hurricane capital of the world. Many folks go with this product here on the left, the closed cell, because since it is rigid, when you spray it on the underside of the roof decking, it kind of super glues your roof together. But a big difference between one and the other is this one here, the open cell. If you were to look at it under a microscope, it would look kind of like a sponge. It's porous. So if I were to pour a little bit of water here at the top, within a few minutes down at the bottom here, the water will seep right through it. Not the case with the closed cell insulation on the left. This pretty much will not let water get through it. So in many places where you don't want water to get through the area, this is what you would put in. And of course, there is pricing differences between the two, but you also want to look at what the R value is per inch. Obviously, you're going to get a higher R value on the product on the left, the closed cell, than you would on the product on the right, but it is going to cost you a little bit more money. If all it is that you're looking for is making a room the temperature a lot steadier, like for instance on a two-story home where upstairs it's very hot in the summertime here in Florida, then what you would go with is the open cell. And with this product here, the open cell, you do not need to enclose the attic area, or you do need to close the attic area to make it work better. With the closed cell, you can leave your attic vented, meaning the way that most homes are built here in Florida, you have a vented attic. You can spray this on the underside of the roof decking, keep your existing ceiling insulation, and have your attic vented. Now, if you opt with the open cell, you want to encapsulate the attic or seal it from the outside so no more ventilation. But the attic insulation that's on the ceiling floor, your ceiling insulation, you want to go ahead and remove that. Otherwise, it can cause a mold issue. So, if you do have any questions regarding the information, you can go to our website at www.flgreenteam.com. Or you can reach our office at 239-432-1500. Hope the video was educational. If you have any questions, like mentioned before, you can reach us at our website or our phone number. Thank you.